Hey, what's up, guys? This is Mark Angel coming at you for the first time in a very, very, very long time. And I miss you guys, so here I am. How do I begin? I haven't spoken to you guys in such a long time, so let's catch up. I was actually speaking to a friend of mine recently, someone who's vastly become a very good friend of mine recently, and he was asking me about my upcoming project, my upcoming recording project, Angel Dust. If you don't know, the name of the project is Angel Dust. Those who've been following me on Twitter and Facebook and now Tumblr know that the project is entitled Angel Dust. And he was asking me, well, you know, how are you going to present the project to your fans outside of just the packaging of music? And I was like, what do you mean? And so he said, well, you know, maybe you should take a different approach. Maybe you should, you know, record the process of the Angel Dust project. Maybe let them see a more vulnerable side of you outside of just the packaging of music. And he said, just take a new approach. And so it's a bit foreign to me because I don't normally verbalize my biography, my diary, except through music. So this is a little bit different. So that's what I'm going to take him up on a suggestion. He's very, very smart. And I'm laughing because it's an inside joke between him and I. So he and I. So anyway, Angel Dust. Speaking about that, he was saying, you know, be more vulnerable. And at the time, I figured, well, be more vulnerable. I'm kind of vulnerable through my music already. But he was like, just be more vulnerable. And I was taking it as, you know, having these self-defining sort of woe is me moments on video. But no, I can define it the way, I realize I can define vulnerability the way I need to define vulnerability in this process. And for me, that vulnerability is categorized right now in being thankful, being grateful, showing humility and humbleness about my experiences, specifically over the past few years. If you haven't noticed, today is Valentine's Day. And it's the year to the day that life-changing events happened to me in my life. And I don't want, it's a year later, but I don't want to take, you know, that time to, like I said, be vulnerable in a woe is me moment or describe Angel Dust in a woe is me moment, because Angel Dust is not about a woe is me moment. Angel Dust is about the last year, but more so it's about the product of the last year. And it's about being thankful. It's about being grateful, like I said. And so I want to just take this opportunity right now to be thankful to my friends and family who who have been very supportive of me and loving of me over the past year. I mean, throughout my life, but specifically through the past year. Other people that have come into my life that have been just good to me and have been supportive of me and been bridges for me to continue this, continue life. And I also want to take the opportunity to be thankful and grateful to, trying to tear up now, to you guys, the fans, the supporters, the listeners who have been completely and totally supportive and relentless in their support of Mark Angel, in support of this whole LGBT movement. Oh my gosh, I'm not supposed to cry. I'm not supposed to have an open moment on camera without Oprah standing here. But you guys have been completely and totally incredible over the past year and throughout my career. I just want to take the time to take this moment of vulnerability to thank you all. It's been a crazy year. And those who are close to me know what I'm talking about. And Angel Dust is not going to be about this past year. Angel Dust is going to be about the product of this past year. And that's the discovery of myself, self-love, the learning to put Mark first, it's about self-love. It's a story of finding me, which is so ironic. Finding the real me and being happy with being me despite the stuff that's happened over the past year. It's about Angel Dust, being high on self, being high on self-love, discovering self, realizing that it's okay to be happy. It's okay to try to be happy. It's okay to fight to be happy. Self-encouragement, self-empowerment. That's what Angel Dust is about. So, since I've taken up the last 8 minutes speaking about that, I don't want to forget to be thankful to God through this journey. I've discovered very much so, especially on this day last year, that God is real. Whether you call him God, whether you call him the universe, whether you call him Jehovah, Yahweh, whatever you want to call him, call it, call her. I discovered over the, specifically this day last year and over the last year, that God is real, that he does exist, and that I do have purpose here. And the purpose is not just music. The purpose is to speak about and sing about my experience and hopefully encourage and inspire other people at the same time growing myself. So, That's what angel dust is about. So I'm going to be doing these a little bit more often. I'm going to be connecting with you guys a little more often. Outside of just songs. I'm going to try to do this to document the experience of angel dust. The experience of Mark Angel. And hopefully you guys will be inspired this way as well, outside of just the music and the packaging or the housing of music, which is easy for me. You know, that part is easy for me. This is a little bit more difficult. It's because it's new. So, as I stop crying, but I'm not crying because of sorrow. I'm crying because of joy, because I'm here. I'm alive. I'm experiencing this, and I'm so happy and so grateful that I'm able to share that experience with you all as well. So, I love you. As I always say, live in love. Live in love. And I thank you. If I haven't said enough, I thank you. And, oh gosh, you guys. I love you, and I'll see you soon, okay?